We're at the New Life Evangelistic Center, Veterans Coming Home Center in Springfield, Missouri. It's the largest day shelter in southwestern Missouri, northwestern Arkansas. Be sure you stay tuned. I'm Larry Rice, and this is Here's Help. With the Veterans Coming Home Center in Springfield, Missouri. I'm with Joe Batson, and Joe coordinates the work here. And behind me is a statue of the homeless Jesus. And that is in front of a place where people had no place to sleep last night or sleeping right now during the day here at the Veterans Coming Home Center. Joe, this place reaches a lot of people, doesn't it?
Yes, it does. We're averaging around 200 people per day that come in and receive services here at the facility.
Largest walk-in shelter, not only in Springfield, but all of southwestern Missouri, northwestern Arkansas, a place for people to go to have nowhere to go.
Exactly.
Yep. You know, with the homeless Jesus statue right here in front of where the people behind me are sleeping, Wow, it brings to total reality, even as it takes place. People that often, many of them slept outside during the night, park benches all over the place. And now, during the day, they have a place to rest, don't they?
Yes, they do. There's a lot of places they can come in and sleep here on the cots that we have here. They can lay down here at the couches, or they can just lay their head down on the table. A lot of times people just come in and do that.
There are many needs we're facing right now. Primarily, as I look around here, I see buckets out, the roof's leaking. We got to get the roof fixed. The floor, it needs to be repaired. I mean, there's just some tremendous needs here that we need people to really recognize how critical this place is and rally to the cause, don't we?
Exactly. This is the only place that's open on the weekends here in the Springfield area. A lot of times, if it's a weekend or a holiday, there is no place for people to go. The library's closed on Sunday. Bill's Place is the only other place that I'm aware of that takes people in during the week. But like I said, they're not open on the holidays or the weekends.
And we're open all weekend, and we're open all week long. We never, 365 days out of the year, aren't we?
Never close. We're always open.
And when they come in here, I see a free store. I see people back there on the computers. I see a library. I see a kitchen. And they have laundry facilities, a lot of things, as well as a place for people to come together who are homeless.
Yep, come in and get a hot shower. A lot of people wanted to come in and get a hot shower today. We serve meals twice a day. Yep, we sure do help a lot of people. I think we had probably 60 or 70 people in a free store this morning.
And that's in addition to all the rest of them that are using all the other services. Again, we urgently need your help here at the New Life Evangelistic Center in Springfield, Missouri, a part of the New Life Evangelistic Center headquartered in St. Louis. It's P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, the 63166, the place where your gift goes so far as you reach out through the love of Jesus, directly impacting people's lives for good. Please get involved now.
I'm Brother Bill Bates at Veterans Coming Home Center in Springfield, Missouri. And I'd like to thank Brother Rice's ministry in part, and I just want to thank God that the help that I've got from him, and I'm glad to be born again in Spirit-filled, and praying for everybody in Missouri and other places that this telecast goes to. And Brother Harold just asked me to say a word of exhortation, and I'm just glad to be here today. And praise God.
Hi, I'm Crystal, and I'm volunteering, and I'm just thankful to give back. A lot of us single moms have had a hard year, and that's the best thing to do to help overcome sadness is think about somebody else and give. And if it wasn't for the help that some of us have received, we would be here ourselves. And these are just wonderful people, and it's a really great place and organization to be giving back to these people.
Thank God for our dedicated volunteers and for those who are sharing with New Life Evangelistic Center. Tell us your name.
I'm Jewel.
Jewel, what does it mean, this place right here, that the New Life Evangelistic Center's Day Outreach Center?
It's the difference between life and death. On most days, it's food, it's shelter, it's, like I said, the computers are a lifeline to my family. And
you use a computer a lot to keep touch with your family?
Yes, sir, and it's very valuable to me.
I mean, a lot of people come into this place, don't they?
Yes, they do. You, me, to everybody, you know. And, you know, I've been a pillar of society, and here I am struggling. And
how did it happen?
Oh, just a struggle. I had gotten in trouble, and I ended up in prison. When I got home, I didn't have anything left. So I've had a hard time bouncing back.
Society can be very unforgiving, can't it?
Oh, yes. Yes, it is. And as a felon, I have a hard time getting housing. I have a hard time with employment. Just all of it. I have to have a job because I have to pay taxes, but I get no say, no representation for that.
And it's individuals such as yourself that Jesus said in Matthew 25, when I was hungry, did you feed me? Naked, did you clothe me?
Yes.
Sick or in prison, did you visit me? A stranger, homeless, did you welcome me? Let's take a look over here for a moment. This is the homeless Jesus statue. You see that? Nail prints in the feet? You know it's Jesus, okay? And he's on a park bench. Remember Matthew 8:20 where he said, foxes have holes, birds have nests, but he, the Son of Man, had nowhere to lay his head?
Yes, sir.
And when you look here, all wrapped up here, you don't see a face. If we want to see the face, we have to look into your face and the face of others that are homeless.
Thank you, sir.
And how does it make you feel to know that Jesus would identify with your daily struggles like this?
It overwhelms me. And I feel I'm blessed no matter what the situation, because if I truly need, it will be provided.
Rejected often by people and society as a whole?
Yes, sir.
You know, alone?
Very
but
much.
Yet he's promised, he said, I will never leave you nor will I ever forsake you.
Exactly. I walk with God.
Is that encouraging to you?
Yes, sir. Very much.
Quite a few people come in and they sleep here during the day
because
many have been up all night.
Many times I've had to walk through the night and so happy that you've opened the door so I could fall asleep here where I know it would be safe.
Sleep's pretty important, isn't it?
Yes, it is. And they've clothed me with all my clothes, boots on my feet because it is important to have good shoes and warm clothing. And
we thank those that donate, don't we?
Very much, very much
we
so.
We thank each and every one of you. And if you have not yet sent your Christmas gift to New Life Evangelistic Center, please do it now. $390,000 is needed by Christmas. And $50,000 of that is for the facilities here in Springfield, the roof that's got to be repaired. In addition to that, we have the floors that have to be done, other work that needs to be done.
Yes, sir.
We need people praying and sharing now.
Yes, sir.
The needs right here in Springfield, along with what we're facing in New Bloomfield, Missouri, the roofs have to be repaired, and that's a training center there. So $50,000 needed for those two locations. Please pray for New Life Evangelistic Center and share at this time and the rest of the money. Let's urgently need to pay overdue bills. Continue to help New Life Evangelistic Center's battle to shelter the homeless in St. Louis. So many different areas New Life's at. We're going to be there when people are hurting. And the homeless, they're so thankful for what God is doing through you, each and every one of you that are caring at this time. May God bless you in a very special way.
All right, my name is James Walker. They call me The Walks. I've been homeless for about 2 years. The VA has helped me with clothes, some resources that I needed to go stay, that I could go sleep at. And they've been helping feed me, so.
Hey, my name is Austin. I am Austin Jasky. I'm 20 years old. I come to the Salvation Army almost every day. I've been homeless for 2.5 years. The holiday is coming up. I've seen people happier, but they're still dragging. Facilities helped me out with clothing. I came in soaked one day. They gave me a towel.
Hi, this is Tommy Lee. I've been homeless for over 7 years, and with Larry Rice's building, I don't think I would ever be in the position to where I have a job and other necessities like food, clothes, a place to be able to take a shower, a place of rest, a place to be able to spread the gospel. And
hi, this is Joe here at the Veterans Coming Home Center in Springfield, Missouri. I'd like to thank everybody for all the donations that we've been receiving here at the Veterans Coming Home Center. I'd also like to encourage you to please, if you can, give as much as you can. We've got a couple of issues here at the property. We've got a roof leak that we need to take care of. That's going to be around $20,000. And our flooring, we need some help with our flooring. The carpeting is pretty much needing to be replaced. So if there's anyone out there that hears this and you're able to help, we sure would appreciate it. God bless.
If it hadn't been for the help of the volunteers here, my sanity wouldn't be back. I had a nervous breakdown, and with the help of the workers here, I've come back from the fringes of insanity, from hopelessness and loss that I felt was so great that I couldn't recover. And so now I have camaraderie and compassion, and friends, and I have the basic necessities that I need, and this place is very, very needed and helpful for all of us on a daily basis. You know, we sometimes grumble and groan about the rules or whatever, but they're there to help us and help us become more established citizens of society.
Hello, folks. My name is Robert Alf.
I know you are.
I am homeless. It's been off and on for about the last 5 years. This place here has been a great help. It's a godsend. It helps a lot of people. Other than veterans, it helps the homeless, and I'm grateful for that. I'm grateful for the seasons that come around, especially this time of year, because it brings me closer to my God, as I understand Him.
My name is Joe Casey. I'm thankful for many blessings of the Lord. I'm thankful for this VA staff. I'm thankful for a nice day that we can all love each other and be blessed. We thank you for keeping us warm, and we always are grateful for the food that the people bring in. God bless.
I'm homeless because it's myself. It's not nobody else's problem. I'm the one who put myself here. I'm the one who dig myself out. And with help of people like this and other places, establishments that are there to help, if people would take the initiative to find out about them, life will change. But you have to have a little faith and a little trust in other people. I appreciate the time. Thank you.
Talking to Mr. Jeffries at this time, and sir, you're without a home. How important is this place to you, Darren?
This place is very important. I think Reverend Rice has a good club facility here. It helps people out that don't have jobs. They have computer skills they could take, you know, food and clothing they give away, and I think his ministry does 100% correct on helping people.
And we really do need your help. We need you to join us right now at the New Life Evangelistic Center at the Veterans Coming Home Center in Springfield, Missouri. We definitely need to get the roof fixed here, the floor fixed here. In addition to the other needs that we're facing at New Life Evangelistic Center, please go to God and pray for a Christmas miracle this year. There are so many people that are in need. Yes, we had a major battle trying to get this place open when we first got involved. We had the school, we had to invite the city, the county. We received this former Social Security building, and we are now working to continue to just help so many people that are in need. We do have a special house for veterans to spend the night in, but so many of the homeless at large come in here every day. I mean, we'll have over 200 people a day. A lot of people come in here, don't have any much other places to go during the day.
That's correct, and anybody that could contribute anything to Reverend Rice's program should do so.
And we really thank God. I mean, you're hearing from the people who are benefiting. Your gift goes so far at the New Life Evangelistic Center. Again, it's P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. And I thank God for those of you that are just letting your light be shining at this time and reaching out and helping at this hour of need.
Tasha, could you give our viewers a little idea of how you became homeless and how you found out about the Vet Center?
Yes, we don't have just suddenly no place to go because he cannot live where he is. I go with him. And he was just scared. He got, and he's hiding. And I find that woman said to sleep from window. And they give me information for the VA center. And I didn't know about the VA center till I come. This is a really great place to come. Really, really.
Did one door tell you about us?
Yes, and it cannot be closed because everybody gonna be dying on the street if PA's not closed.
Yeah. We're not gonna close. We're confident that Jesus is gonna provide shelter for his lambs. Okay, so please don't think that's gonna happen. Okay, we're gonna trust in God to provide all of our needs. Okay.
Thank you.
You're welcome. God bless you. He has, and we're passing him along.
Thank you for the very rise and learning this place.
Yep.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
It's Jesus who strengthens the people, helped them to continue to keep going, even in the midst of homelessness and adversity day after day. Christ gives them the strength, and you can testify to that?
I can. I went to prison for 10 years of my life, and during that time that I was homeless, I lost my parents while I was in prison. Both my parents died. I had so much hatred in my heart, so much hatred. I became an alcoholic, a drug addict. And while I was in prison, I spent the first 2 years just hating everybody, just keeping in my cell, staying to myself. And I got out of prison in 2014, and God just turned my whole life around. I mean, ever since He stepped into my life, I can't even express the love and the joy I have from Him. I mean, He's really changed my life. He just fills me with His love. He pours out His blessings upon me.
And you're saying that even though right now you are homeless, you're out of prison, and the blessings. Do you see this particular place as one of those blessings?
I do. Joe is really a fantastic person. He takes people in. He helps people to get the things that they need: blankets, sleeping bags, clothing, bus passes, food. I mean, if it weren't for this place and other places like this, St. Louis, where you're from, people need to hear the Word of God. They need to know that God loves them with a love that is unconditional. His grace is what keeps me going. I'm 64 years old.
Everyone, your name?
I'm 65. My name's Peter Garcelon, and I'm from Maine. And God, His grace just keeps us going. It strengthens us every day.
Yes.
I can live on His promises, knowing that what He says He will do, He will do. And there's a lot of people out there that say there is no God. I got news for them. Yes, there is. And if they need that proof that God is real, all they got to do is, after a storm, look up in the clouds. God made a promise with Noah. He said, "I shall put my bow in the sky as a reminder never to flood the earth again."
And in the midst of our own personal storms, all we have to do is call out unto the Lord and see how Jesus is that way, the truth, and the life.
Yes.
And He will save, He will deliver, He will strengthen, He will preserve, and He will keep you. Even as this brother, in the midst of his homelessness, giving glory to God. And so many of you know that, but in the midst of your affluence, in the midst of your abundance, will you share so we can continue to keep sharing that there is hope? Christ is risen to that so many that are in need. So many the fatherless, the widowed, the hurting, the homeless. Amen.
Amen. And
many
I'll tell you,
this place every day. A lot of people come in here.
A lot of people. I remember it was last winter. I didn't have any place to go. And this is before I really got to know Joe real good. I was sleeping right out in front of this building, and a woman collapsed, and she was crying out, and she said, "Lord, help me, Lord, help me, I'm so cold, I'm so cold." I got out of my sleeping bag, and I went over, and I picked her up, and I helped her over to my sleeping bag, and I said, "Lady," I said, "take my sleeping bag." And I let her sleep in my sleeping bag right out front of this building. And I walked the streets that night, and all I could do all the time I walked the streets, even though I was cold, I just praised God and said, "Thank you for that opportunity, Father." I said, "That's what it's all about."
And in a moment's notice, we would be having this place open all night long, except we're battling it in Springfield, so what do? We open it all day where they can sleep, and invite them into training programs and try to help them. That's why we're fighting so hard to keep it open all night in St. Louis and going to it, take it all the way to the Supreme Court. Right now, you have to understand that this particular building, provided through Health and Human Services, and New Life Evangelistic Center has to wait to 30 years before we actually get the title. We've been quite a few years into it here. So it's a different situation, but we're using every moment, every hour, everything we can do to help those in need and welcome them in. Get them in the sleeping bags, trying to equip them for service, trying to let them know that there's hope, Christ is risen. We don't want them freezing out there on those streets. We want them to come on in and be helped and get involved in training programs.
And
reach out through the love of Jesus in every way, all day long.
To me, being able to have a place to come to, have a place where I can sit down, read a Bible, talk with people, witness to people, that's what it's all about.
Amen.
It's all about spreading the love of Jesus Christ to a dying world, because, man, if we don't do it, who's gonna? And besides that, God says that works without faith is dead. If
and so
you know,
we have to let our light shine. And
I carry this everywhere I go. Everywhere I go, and I love sharing the Word of God because, man,
well,
a lot of people don't realize that the moment you ask Christ into your life, an angel writes your name in the book of life.
Thank you, Jesus.
Jesus said, "In my Father's kingdom are many mansions,
yes,
and
Lord.
I go to prepare a place for you that you may be with me."
Thank
that's
you, Jesus.
That is
a
promise.
Promise
that you can stand on.
Well,
a
no.
promise that's so great.
And when you don't have a home here, to have that promise. And we're sharing that promise with everyone. That's why the homeless Jesus is a reminder of that. And what he's called all of us to do in the midst of these needs. And if you know anybody needs a sleeping bag, bring them in. You need to know anybody who needs a place to sleep during the day, bring them in. Anybody needs to use the computers or showers or food or clothing, bring it in. And get them into training programs that we have at New Life Evangelistic Center. We're using this former Social Security building in this way. Federal surplus property, the law says it's supposed to be used to help the homeless, and yet less than 1% is actually going that way. I'm asking you to pray for us here at New Life Evangelistic Center as we go back to Joe.
Hello, we're here with Patty in Springfield at the Veterans Coming Home Center. Could you tell our viewers a little bit about yourself, please?
I'm homeless, and I stay here. They get out of the code.
How did you become homeless?
I couldn't get a job.
Yeah, the economy's not doing too good. How did you find out about the vet center?
The one door.
One door told you about us?
Yeah.
Do you feel safe when you come here?
Yeah, yeah.
Do you come in and get some clothes and get some food?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Do you think that people should support us and keep us open?
Yeah, yeah.
I sure do thank you for talking to us. You try to have a good day, okay?
Okay.
You are literally touching so many people's lives, so many individuals, as you share with the New Life Evangelistic Center, whether it's in St. Louis or Springfield or other locations. Tell us your name.
James.
James, how has it changed your life by coming here to the New Life Evangelistic Center's Veterans Coming Home Center in Springfield?
It inspired me to get off meth.
It freed you from the drugs?
Yeah.
Have you given your life to Jesus?
Yep, finally.
And finally gave it to him?
Yeah.
And it's delivering you from the drugs?
Oh, bigger than crap.
It's changing your life?
Yeah, altering.
Wow. So how important is this particular facility here at 806 North Jefferson?
Highly, highly. They help out so many people here. It's unbelievable. It's totally godsend.
You feel like it's something God is really using?
Yes, very much so.
And all of you that are supporting the work are a part of that at this moment, letting God work in you and through you. You are touching lives. What a mighty God we serve. You used to have a pretty bad drug problem?
Very bad. Very bad.
Robbed you everything you had?
Yep. Yep. Took my family, and I finally got back with my wife after being clean a year, and she's got serenity prayer tattooed on her chest and stuff, and we're staying strong.
You gave it all to Christ.
Yep.
This place, you come in through it all day long. How important is it to you?
It's highly important. It keeps me off the drugs. Me being busy up here volunteering with Joe and stuff keeps mm-hmm. me away from drug dealers. So.
And we thank God for those of you that are
Joe.
Making it possible here. Yes, and how God works through the different staff here at New Life Evangelistic Center. Same way he works through you as you share that much-needed tax-deductible gift with New Life Evangelistic Center at P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. Thank you for letting your light shine. Thank you for touching so many people's lives.
Hi there. We're here at the Veterans Coming Home Center. We're in the library with Ken. Ken's the volunteer that's been working working really hard to get the library together for everybody to come in and enjoy. Ken, is there anything you got to say to the folks out there?
Yeah, I need shelves, at least 10 more, preferably metal or solid wood, no particle board, because it don't hold up. I don't know, I think I need about 10 more shelves altogether to get all of this on the shelf so it's in the middle aisle, so that they can walk around and look at the books and without having to pick up four or five of them like they were on the tables when I first got here. That's not a table has a place in the library only for use with computers. We don't need tables in a library. We need shelves. Put the books up so people can look at them.
Okay, so if you're out there and you're hearing this, please, if you can, donate some shelves here to the Veterans Coming Home Center Library. We can get a lot more books out for the people to come in into it and enjoy. Ken, looks like you got a Marine Corps cap on. Are you a Marine?
Did 6 years in the Corps. Didn't make a man out of you, nothing would.
Vietnam vet?
Yes, sir. 18 months.
So here we have a retired Marine Vietnam vet here at the Veterans Coming Home Center, volunteering to help everyone else come in and enjoy the library and get a nice book to read. So if there are any vets out there that are listening to this, any Marines out there, if you can come in and donate a bookshelf, donate a book, a magazine, a newspaper, it sure would be appreciated. God bless.
I've been homeless since September 14th, September 14th. And it's the first time in my life that's ever happened to me. It's 60 years old. And there's lots of places to get assistance for food and showers. And this has been one of the best places, the only place that you can get really a shower consistently that I know of. There may be other places. But yeah, they're helpful. The staff is helpful, considerate. Everybody, they try to get tell everybody to be considerate of each other. And we need more places like this, more people like them, and more help for the homeless is really needed in Springfield. But thanks, VA.
We call it the Veterans Coming Home Center. We have an emphasis on veterans, but everyone's welcome here at 806 North Jefferson, the New Life Evangelistic Center. We need individuals really praying now that we can get this roof fixed. And when it rains, a lot of rain comes through, doesn't it?
Yes, and especially since it's been raining a couple of days here in a row, we've got a lot of leaks. We've got a lot of, if you notice in the ceiling, we've got a lot of tiles missing. We've got a lot of buckets on the floor catching the water. It would definitely be a blessing if we could have some help getting this fixed.
Right, and some flooring in here, and we just really want to continue to keep helping so many people and that literally have nowhere at all to go, right?
Exactly. This is the largest respite area in southern Missouri, northern Arkansas. What we need to do is we need to keep helping the homeless. I don't know if people realize this or not, but if you want to be in the book of life with Jesus, you have got to help the homeless, you've got to feed the hungry, you've got to clothe the naked, and you have got to, excuse me, to visit the sick and visit them in prison. This is what our Lord, if you claim to be a Christian and you claim that Jesus is your Lord, this is what your Lord commands you to do. So we have to do these things.
And again, I emphasize the fact we are saved by grace. God takes the initiative. But if you've experienced true salvation, it's not going to just be me, Lord. It's going to be us. It's going to be Jesus, what do you want me to do? It's going to be recognizing the homeless Jesus as he comes to us in behalf of the hurting and the homeless, the fatherless, the widowed. And he says, as Joe was referring to in Matthew 25, as oft you've done to the least of these, even so you've done it unto me. If you're alive in Christ, his life's going to flow through you into the lives of the hurting and the homeless. What we do at New Life Evangelistic Center is give you those opportunities. Go to www.newlifeevangelisticcenter.org and see all the opportunities awaiting you. And then share that much-needed tax-deductible gift as you partner with New Life so we can fix the roof here, fix the floor. Pay these overdue bills. Meet the needs. Encourage your family, your friends, your relatives to get involved. If you want more of the New Life and actions that share this need, call 314-881-3218. Tell us how many you'd like, how many Christmas envelopes you'd like. 314-881-3218. But please let your light shine. Daily we see so many hurting people come to these various centers, don't we, Joe?
Yes. Yes, every day we're open. We never close. And every day we have more and more people coming in needing help. So, you know, please partner with New Life Evangelistic Center and help us help the hurting.
And you can do that again. You can give online at www.newlifeevangelisticcenter.org, or you can directly send that gift to P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. And let your light so shine before men and women that may see your good works and glorify our Father who is in heaven. Again, thank you for those of you that are caring and sharing at this critical hour.